Okay, now see this question. This question is based on projectile motion. A particle is projected from the ground such that it touches the four corners of a regular hexagon of side length A, as shown in the figure. Find the corresponding horizontal range on the ground and the time of flight. So here we have a regular hexagon. It doesn't look like a regular one, but it's a regular one. The diagram is slightly skewed. And here, this is the projectile motion. The particle flies such that it touches the four corners of the hexagon. Okay, so we have to find the range and time of flight. So since the previous diagram was not clear, so here I have drawn another diagram. This is your regular hexagon. Okay, the side of the hexagon is equal to A, and this is the projectile trajectory of the particle. Okay, so we have to find the horizontal range, okay, and time of flight. So let's say this is your range. Now let's say that initially the particle has velocity along x and y axis. So velocity along x axis of the particle is ux, and velocity along y axis is uy. Correct. Now obviously the x component of velocity is never changing because the horizontally there is no acceleration. So ux remains constant. Second thing, let's apply some geometry. So if I construct over here, this is 90, this is 90, this angle will be 60 degree because of a regular hexagon. Okay, so this side is equal to A, so this will be how much? A cos 60, so A by 2. So this side will be A by 2, this is A, and this is again A by 2, correct? A by 2, A by 2. Now, if you observe something, if I draw one more line over here, then I am dividing this side exactly into four equal parts. A by 2, A by 2, A by 2, and A by 2. Now start from here, let's name the coordinates. So this is my coordinate A, B, and this is the coordinate C. Okay, there's a small error. This is A by 2, right? So the horizontal displacement while going from A to B is A by 2. And the horizontal displacement while going from B to C is again A by 2. Horizontal distance from A to B is A by 2. Horizontal distance from B to C is also A by 2. That means time to go from A to B is equal to time to go from B to C. So let's just write that this is equal to T. Now let's name a few more things. This height is Y. And this height is how much? From here I can find the height over here. A sine 60 degree will give me this height to be equal to A root 3 by 2. So this will be A root 3 by 2. Okay. Now, if you look at the motion along Y axis, in the motion along Y axis, for constant acceleration, okay, for constant acceleration and initial velocity 0, initial velocity 0, the distance covered in equal time intervals is in the ratio 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7 and so on. Okay. That is, if you look over here, for the motion along Y axis, when going from A to B, the particle covers a vertical height of Y. When going from B to C, the particle covers a vertical height of A root 3 by 2. But both the heights are covered in same time. So that means Y is to A root 3 by 2 will be equal to 1 is to 3 according to this, because at point A initial velocity along y axis will be 0. At the point A velocity along y axis is 0, so from A to B and from B to C the ratio will be equal to 1 is to 3. Okay, so from here we can easily find y value of y. So y divided by A root 3 by 2 is equals to 1 by 3, or y will be A by 2 root 3. So since we found y, we can now find a total height of projectile motion, maximum height. So y plus A root 3 by 2, this height is also A root 3 by 2. So the max height of projectile is y plus a root 3 by 2 plus a root 3 by 2, right? Y plus a root 3 by 2 plus a root 3 by 2. So we get this to be equal to a by 2 root 3 plus a root 3. So this is equal to 7 a by 2 root 3. Okay. This is the maximum height of projectile. Now, so we can easily find the time of flight. The time taken to cover this whole height. Okay, that is time taken to go from A up to the ground. So time of flight will be can be found easily. So time taken to reach, time to go from A to ground will be root 2h by g. So time of flight will be total 2h by g, time to go up plus time to come down. Okay, so we found the time of flight. This is equal to 2 root 2 by g, and h is 7a by 2 root 3. 7a by 2 root 3. So this is 2 root 7a by g root 3. This is your time of flight. Now, how to find the range? So that is also very easy. Now find the time taken to go from A to B. So that's very easy. Time to go from A to B, that is t, will be equal to root 2y by g. Okay, and then this length will be how much? This length will be equal to velocity along x-axis into time. So ux multiplied by t, but ux multiplied by t is equal to a by 2. So that's what we can write down. So a by 2 is equal to ux multiplied by t. T is how much? Root 2y by g. So a by 2 equal to ux t equal to ux root 2y by g. Okay. So a by 2 equal to ux root 2 times. Y is how much? Y is a by 2 root 3. A by 2 root 3. Okay. So ux will be equal to root a g root 3 by 2. And now we can easily find the range. So the range will be equal to ux into time of flight.